We are super excited. We have a very special guest. She is a musician on YouTube. She has a number one channel in Australia, and she has accumulated over 1.3 billion views. Wengie!
Yay!
Hey. You make me sound so good. I'm like, that's me? Are they talking about me? Is this someone else? I need some self-love to get you off my mind. My girls, we laser, and then we batter eyes. A little bit of lace in your face, gonna put it in motion.
Is there anything upcoming that all your fans out there need to know about?
I collabed with a really big artist from the Philippines,
okay.
Inigo Pascual.
Hey!
Yeah!
Ooh, that's gonna be fire.
Yeah, and we actually sung a version of this song in Tagalog.
As well as English.
That's so it's going to be a hybrid. So it's like really taking that diversity to the next level, including the native language.
Did it in Tagalog and in English.
Oh my God.
She's crazy talented. Now we gotta do Chinese next time.
Yeah, you gotta sing Chinese.
Right?
I can't coach you, but. So I went to Australia when I was 4, so I was like quite young, and I felt completely Australian until I went to school and I didn't look like everyone else. It was just like little cultural things that stood out for me, like when you bring weird food to school, everyone's just like, what is that? Like, I knew I was a little bit different, but it also led me to discover great Asian pop music. But I never really found any artist or pop star that kind of looked like me. So I naturally gravitated towards listening to J-pop, C-pop, and K-pop. I get deja vu. I started off my music career in China, and it was an amazing experience because it really showed me what it was like to work in the music industry. I took that learning experience and I really wanted to do it myself. I really wanted to bring that to American pop, which is also a genre I absolutely love, and make this fusion that is both K-pop and American pop, and also make sure it's like completely diverse and have people of all races and ethnicities in my videos, and give that thing that I was looking for growing up, where I wanted to see more different faces, especially Asian faces in American entertainment.
Music has always been something I wanted to do my whole entire life, but it's something I'm always telling myself, like, no, you're not a singer, like, you can't do it. And after all, I'm just like, who am I to say that I can't? Like, you know, internet loves to tell you that you can't do things. I want to show people that you can, because that's what I stand for.
My parents definitely didn't agree with my career choice. In fact, I didn't even tell them I was doing it. They wanted me to be an accountant because I was, you know, grew up in an Asian household. It was like, study hard, get good grades, go to college, and get a stable job, which I did, but I was kind of like miserable. So on the side, after work, I decided to work on my own projects just because I knew it wasn't the life I signed up for.
Can you imagine telling your Asian parents that you're not gonna be a doctor, lawyer, accountant anymore, and you're gonna quit your job and be unemployed?
When they found out I was the number one YouTuber in Australia, like, they were excited. I think by that time they've kind of just come to terms with the fact that I wasn't gonna be pursuing the traditional job path, so I'm really glad they came around to that.
Dance for a lot of my life, and what I love about K-pop and Asian pop in particular is how they incorporate dance choreography to all their music, and it becomes a big part of the song. Obviously, like, I don't know the language very well, so sometimes even just dancing is a way of like sharing my love and passion for the song.
Up, down, up, down, stop, tick-tick-tack.
Right now, I don't see a lot of Asian women or men in mainstream music, and I'm really excited to hear like Blackpink's at Coachella and BTS being recognized. That's like the first step towards more diversity in the industry. The music video is called Lace Up, a new song, and it's all about like empowering women. It's about a girl that went through like a bad breakup but now realizes that she doesn't need him and all she needs is herself. My style is definitely inspired by K-pop and Asian pop, so you're gonna see a lot of dance choreography, bright colors, cool quick camera angle cuts, and just, yeah, very, very inspired by how they do it. It's beautiful and I love it. I think it's really great to be able to represent my Chinese culture. My first song that I released on YouTube was a music video I did in China, and it was all in Chinese. And it was so great to see how positive the fans received it, because it was in a language they probably never heard of before.
Boys versus girls, baseball game, and I actually don't know how to play baseball, like, whatsoever.
Pretending to be a baseball player with four other dudes and five other girls.
The boys are gonna be making jackasses out of themselves.
And we're gonna win, because girls always win.
Yeah!
We're gonna win.
I think I'm gonna take a hit at the home run plate or something like that, get run over in a baseball game by one of the girls.
I love the concept of it, the inclusion of diversity, so I'm here to represent Latinas.
I think people are gonna see women empowerment, how powerful women are.
Wengie has clearly been practicing. I think she's a low-key baseball player on the side.
My motto in life is dream big, but stay humble. I think it's really important to dream big, achieve a lot of success, and try and be the best person you are, but also stay humble doing it, because I think it's very important for people to see where you came from and where you went to. Stay relatable, stay real, like, don't float up and disappear because you're at this level of success. It's very important to, you know, help people, like, come up as well, that, you know, are where you were when you first started.
I hit the balls. I only missed two balls. I was like, oh no, what if I didn't hit anything? But we got the home run. The video's a home run. The whole team pulled together. Thank you everyone for helping me with this production. It turned out so well. Bye guys, love you.